Hello, today we will discuss about sampling theory. First definition we are going to study here is population or universe. A large collection of numerical data or attributes is known as population. Next, sample. As a small section selected from the population is called sample. Next, sampling. The process of drawing a sample from the population is called sampling. So in this sampling we are having two types. One is sampling with replacement, another one is sampling without replacement. Suppose for these definitions, if I give an example, suppose if you are going to some mall, so we are going to select one shop within that. Let us take a bookshop. So what we entering mall is called as a population or universe, and what we are selecting a bookshop, it is called as a sample, and what we are drawing a book or buying a book from that shop, it is called as a sampling. So in that sampling, we are having two types. One is sampling with replacement, another one is sampling without replacement. So suppose if we are drawing a book, then we can replace it with another book. But suppose if we are drawing a blood from a person, so we cannot replace it. So that is called as without replacement. So let us see these two definitions. What is sampling with replacement and what is sampling without replacement? In sampling with replacement, items are drawn one by one and are put back to population before the next draw. So it is possible. And mean is given by mu and variance is given by sigma squared by n. Next, sampling without replacement. Here, the items are drawn one by one and are not put back to population before next draw. Here, mean is equal to mu and variance is equal to n minus n divided by n minus 1 into sigma squared by n. Next, testing of hypothesis. So first one we'll take here, hypothesis. Hypothesis. To reach decisions about population on the basis of sample information, we make certain assumptions about the population. Such assumptions, which may or may not be true, are called hypothesis or statistical hypothesis. One more time I'll read out. To reach decisions about population on the basis of sample information, we make certain assumptions that about the population. Such assumptions, which may or may not be true, are called hypothesis or statistical hypothesis. Next, null hypothesis. The hypothesis formulated for the purpose of its rejection under the assumption that it is true is called the null hypothesis, and it is denoted by H0. Next, alternate hypothesis. Any hypothesis which is complementary to the null hypothesis is called alternate hypothesis and is denoted by H1. Next, type 1 error. If a hypothesis is rejected while it should have been accepted is called type 1 error. Next, type 2 error. If a hypothesis is accepted while it should have been rejected is called type 2 error. Next, level of significance. The probability level below which we reject the hypothesis is called significance level. Generally, we have 5% or 1% level of significance. in 5% level of significance, 95% will be the confidence level. So in 5% level of significance, the value lies between minus 1.96 to 1.96. I mean, if minus 1.96 is less than Z, less than 1.96, then we accept hypothesis at 5% level of significance. If not, we'll reject the hypothesis. Similarly, in 1% level of significance, 99% confidence will be there, and the value lies between minus 2.58 to 2.58. I mean, if minus 2.58 less than Z less than 2.58, then we accept the hypothesis at 1% level of significance, or else if not, we reject the hypothesis. Next, critical region. The region which contributes for the rejection of hypothesis is called critical region. Next, test of significance. The procedure which enable us to decide whether to accept or reject the hypothesis is called the test of significance. Next, confidence interval. The probability that the population parameter will fall between two set of values for certain population of time is called confidence interval. Next, test of significance and confidence interval for population mean. Suppose we have normal population with mean mu and standard deviation sigma. If x bar is a sample mean of a random sample of size n, then standard normal variate z is defined by z is equal to x bar minus mu divided by sigma divided by root of n. And confidence interval for mu is given by 95% confidence interval is given by x bar plus or minus 1.96 into sigma divided by root of n. And 99% confidence interval is given by x bar plus or minus 2.58 into sigma divided by root of n. Thank you, one and all.